out again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today. 'Cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Now under canopy at 22 miles per hour forward speed from 12,500 feet above the ground. Let's watch as the Golden Knights approach the drop zone.
From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to L.A. Well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the man who died, who gave his life to me. And I gladly stand up next.
With the POWMIA flag coming in, honoring Memorial Day and those who have paid the ultimate sacrifice from 12,500 feet up, a dead center landing for your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Just to the left of show center, I can see the aircraft right now. Golden Knights, you've got it. We've got jumpers in the air, Golden Knights. They're inbound.
More than 70 years ago has since struck fear and terror in the hearts of those foolish enough to oppose them. Relentless in their skill and courage, not only in the air, but also on the ground, these brave soldiers have forged for themselves a place of honor in America's hearts.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Staff Sergeant Nahu Ramirez, originally from Murrieta, California. It has been my proud honor to describe for you today a demonstration of precision freefall as performed by members of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights.
147 aircraft is inbound for the first pass of today's performance.
There they go.
As the aircraft crosses overhead, the jump master gives a crossed arm signal on target.
Rapidly approaching speeds of 120 miles per hour.
Each jumper is now flying together, changing their speed, distance, and rate of closure. Contact has been made, and the 14-inch mahogany baton is staged. Now alter their body positions to form 120 miles per hour spirals in the sky. These jumpers now prepare to separate and deploy their main parachute. Watch closely. There you have the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team.
Mr. Colin Hiller, former team leader of the Eagles aerobatics team, and parachute manufacturer Mr. Steve Snyder, exchanged the first baton in 1958. It was then believed that two jumpers could not possibly make contact with the ball. Jones Beach makes some noise for our two jumpers as they fly over the target area. Watch the minor corrections they use in their steering lines as they bring it over the target. For a safe stand-up landing. Watch as this next jumper flying the New York State flag over the target. She brings it over the target area for a beautiful airborne landing. He will open his first parachute much higher than normal and intentionally cause a malfunction.
Yeah, yawa.
Please do not be alarmed when this first parachute begins to screamer. This is our only solo maneuver, yet one of our most exciting. Watch closely for a black and gold canopy to inflate. This is a perfectly good parachute and can be landed. However, the jumper will reach up and release one side of the parachute, causing it to malfunction. The jumper is now accelerating earthward at speeds in excess of 90 miles per hour. It would be impossible for this jumper to survive at landing under this parachute. So he must release it completely. Return to free fall. And open his main parachute. Make some noise as this jumper brings it over the target area. For a beautiful target area landing. In a sense, it will streak across the sky at 180 miles per hour. As these jumpers execute 180 turns, they are nearly 1.5 miles apart.
due to this tremendous amount of lateral separation, each separate must first locate a thin trail of red smoke on the horizon, then trace it down to his partner, who appears much like a missile, streaking back towards him. Ladies and gentlemen, watch for the cross! Due to the extremely high degree of precision required to complete such a close cross at these violent speeds. The same degree of precision, discipline, and teamwork exhibited by the demonstrators and competitors is also reflected by the Golden Knights Elite Aviation Section. Nicknamed Team 6, the pilots who fly the team aircraft average more than 5,500 flying hours per aviator. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention high overhead. A distinctively painted C-147 aircraft is inbound for the fourth and final pass of today's performance. On this final run, you will experience the world's famous Trident formation. The parachutes have 7 openings on the front. These allow air to be forced in, inflating the flexible wing glider. Make some noise, New York, as this jumper brings it to the target for another space stand-up landing. Diamond in the sky with their smoke trails. As they approach 5,000 feet, the team leader waves his arms, signaling all 3 jumpers to turn and streak to the points of the compass. Watch closely as it completes the bomber's maneuver. This is our salute to all of you attending today's show. Watch for the parachutes. And there you have the high flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Now, as you may have guessed, these jumpers are faced with a unique situation. A traffic jam in the sky. They must gain vertical separation to allow for individual approaches into the target area. Our tandem section provides tandem parachute jumps to selected VIP. Finally, our demonstration team consists of 2 demonstration teams. Since the colors of the Army are black and gold, so are the names of our teams. The team performing for you today is the Black Demonstration Team. These specially selected airborne soldiers demonstrate their skills each year to millions of spectators. Compete in national and international competitions. Help develop new techniques and equipment. And are considered the finest parachuting team in the world. Make some noise, ladies and gentlemen. As the last of our jumpers bring it over the target area. Feel free to contact your local recruiter who is here at today's show. Each member of the team is a soldier first, highly trained in one of the more than 200 specialties available in today's Army. The average Golden Knight is 26 years old, has more than 1,200 parachute jumps. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise as our last of our jumper makes it for a beautiful safe stand-up landing. At the completion of today's performance, we will bring our equipment out to the audience. Come forward and help us repack our parachutes and ask any questions about free fall parachuting and opportunities available to you in today's modern Army. It gives me great pleasure to present the Black Demonstration Team for the 2022 air show season. All members of your United States Army, the Golden Knights. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our performance for the day. And on behalf of the entire team, I would like to thank each and every one of you for being such a warm and receptive airborne audience. In closing, I leave you with this final thought. In the future, may all your days be prosperous and your nights golden.
Ladies and gentlemen, your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Let's hear it.
Long Island.
And speaking of Long Island, it is my pleasure to welcome to the stage David Windmiller.